Hi guys, back with me Dewi for I Indonesia, where you will see Indonesia from the eyes of the locals. From the previous episode, I moved more to the east, and this is just what they call with the island of the spices. Where am I? I am in Ternate! Ternate is located in north of Maluku. What does Ternate has to offer? Let's explore together. Hi guys, this morning we just arrived at Cengkeh Apo. My friends say that this is a place with the oldest cloth tree in the world. So I'm quite curious, let's go. It will take around 15 to 20 minutes to get up. Let's go.
This Cengkeh Apo is located on the foot of the famous Gamalama mountain. It is around 6 kilometers from the heart of Ternate.
As we climb the stairs, there are a lot of cloths, but also nutmeg trees. So it's quite breezy up here because everywhere we are surrounded by trees. Let's go. While we're walking, I saw this behind me. This is the house of those who would take care of this whole area. It's quite interesting, right? I would actually like to have a house like this. So we're finally here. This is thus the oldest cloth tree in the world. So in Latin it would be called Eugenia aromaticum. They say there's actually one that is older than this but died already. So for now this is the oldest.
What does Apo mean? Apo means old in Ternate's local language. And this tree, based on what I read, is 200 years old. This Cengkeh Apo is a cultural heritage, but aside from a small wall that surrounds it, I can't see anything else that indicates that this is a local treasure. Quite a shame, I must say.
As you look around, there will be a lot of nutmeg trees, like this one. I just found this. And I have seen them a lot in the kitchen and maybe in the cafes, but not from nature. Have you ever seen a nutmeg in nature? I've picked one up. Okay. So these guys are dried cloves. We've seen the trees, and this is how it looks like when they are dried. So when it's sunny here, people would actually dry cloves as well as the nutmegs. Like here. From the fresh nutmegs on the trees, this you would see, the dried ones. And inside, there is this. This, they say, is the most expensive part. They would make it into cosmetics. And this is the inner part, the spices that you would find in the kitchen. Right now, we are at Fort Kalamata. This is built by a Portuguese called Antonio Pigafetta. And this is built in 1540. Unlike Dutch architectures, this is only 60 centimeters in thickness and 3 meters tall. Let's see what's inside. This is inside the Fort Kalamata. It is quite big, and if you really see it from above, it would look like a turtle. Interesting. There are a lot of reasons why people travel to certain destinations. And for me, why I travel to Ternate is because of this. I would like to see the actual picture that is on our Indonesian rupiah, the 1000 rupiah. And I'm here. That there is a beautiful view from on top. We're going to take our motorbikes to a lake. Let's see. Wow, nyampe. Wow. Awesome. So this is this called the Lake Ngade, where at the background you can see Maitara. And that big one is Tidore. So throughout the Ternate Island, there are three lakes. This is the Ngade, and then there is Tolire Besar and Tolire Kecil, which means the small one and the big one. I think we're going to take some pictures right now.
This stunning lake is actually called the Laguna Lake, but because it is located in a village called Ngade, it is more famous with the name Ngade Lake. It is 18 kilometers from the city center of Ternate. I swear to you guys that Ternate is too beautiful to be done in just one episode. There are a lot of other spots that you must see, so see you next month!